I'm sitting in court crying, I would have cried too. Okay? He should have had tears coming out his ass. He should have, because he took an innocent life.
Hey lovelies, how's it going? Hope all is well. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with another unfortunate event. However, before I get started, I want to make sure that I say I mean no harm to the family when I do these videos. All of the information in this video is public knowledge, and this is to bring awareness to the cases. Lanaya Bell was a 19-year-old Michigan State University student. Her family and friends described her as a bright, smart, young, vibrant soul.
Nice kid, had everything going for her. Life just ended shortly. Don't know why, don't understand why.
Bell was in her first year at MSU, where she intended to major in business and journalism and one day pursue her goal in becoming a news anchor. As a student at her previous college prep school, she was a member of the National Honor Society, and she went on to attend MSU on an academic scholarship.
Lanaya was a freshman at Michigan State, home on winter break, studying to be a journalist, even visiting WGN studios while she was a junior at North Lawndale Prep.
It was a Friday night in East Chatham. Belle was on winter break, and Belle and Hodges had been dating for about 9 months. A friend of her boyfriend had brought a gun to the house and emptied the bullets onto the bed before Belle's boyfriend started playing with it. Her boyfriend told police that he was play fighting with a revolver he thought was unloaded. He pointed it at himself, another friend, and Belle. According to CBS Local Chicago, he claimed that Belle told him he loved her too much to hurt her when he pointed the gun at her. Of course, nothing happened when he pulled the trigger while pointing the gun at himself and the friend, but as soon as he pointed at Belle, it went off. Officers were called to the scene around 10 p.m. after a witness reporting hearing a gunshot while Belle was in the bedroom. Belle was pronounced dead at the scene. Her boyfriend fled the scene after the shooting and called his mother. According to CBS News, they said that he told his mother he accidentally shot Belle, and she told him to turn himself in. About 6 hours later, he surrendered to the police. Hodges later was charged with one count of involuntary manslaughter. He cried through his mugshot photos as well as his bond hearing that Monday, and the judge set his bail at $50,000, but he was ordered to be held without bond for violating the terms of his earlier bond. The victim's family have a lot of unanswered questions, and they don't believe that this was an accident at all. And a red flag for a lot of people is the fact that the gun was never recovered.
You had 6.5 hours to come up with a story, recruit a witness, get rid of a gun, first degree murder.
They need to look at his history, and they really need to take all this into account.
They basically want the courts to look at his previous history when it comes to this case, and this is what they have found.
Cook County court records obtained by the CBS 2 investigators show that at the time of the shooting, Hodges was on bond for punching and biting a pair of police officers during an arrest in April. He also has a juvenile history of weapons charges, including attempted armed robbery. Bell's family points to his public Facebook page, which shows photos of him holding a gun.
The reason why the family is fighting so hard because Hodges only faced a maximum of 5 years behind bars if convicted.
I think while he was gone for them 6 hours before he turned himself in, he went and got up with somebody and they concocted a story, we got their story together, and went in there and told them people that, and they went for it. Ain't no witnesses. My baby can't speak.
This story is very sad and unfortunate. Lanaya had so much going for her, and it's heartbreaking to hear something like this happen to her, especially everybody involved being 18, 19 years old. This situation happened back in December. It is now January. I tried to look and see if there was any petitions going or anything going on to try to help the case and try to help, you know, the state or whatever prosecutors make sure that it's a lengthier sentence, but I could not find anything. Hopefully someone that knows the family can, you know, reach out so that we can get something going in order for her to get justice. honestly, I just think 5 years is not enough. And if the young man do not have anything to hide, where is the gun? Where is the shells? Like, where is everything? I hate cases like this when it comes to kids. I can relate to this story very well. Back when I was 16 years old, I dated a guy that pulled out a gun on me. I dated a guy that slashed my tires, shot the windows out my car. Like, I've been in some relationships, y'all, and at a very young age. So I can only sympathize with her. The older that I got and the more mature I got, I learned that the characteristics in these men that I was looking for was security. I wanted to feel as if I was protected in the relationship. I had to learn through therapy and through time that that's not the man that I needed. It was just those qualities and characteristics in a man that I wanted. My mom and dad didn't understand it. They knew that I was a smart girl. They only can ask why. So I get it. An 18-year-old, 19-year-old is going to make mistakes, okay? So I just don't want anyone to judge her situation and judge her story. Let's be mindful and respectful in the comments, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for tuning in. Let me know your thoughts and your opinions down below. Love you guys so much. Bye.